morning. Picking pumpkins!
Sunday morning. It's time for us to pick some pumpkins to carve.
Seeds. Pumpkin guts.
And seeds. And
little baked pumpkin babies.
Pumpkin whoopie pies. The place we're going has pumpkin whoopie pies. We're going to a place called Tim's. It's turning into like the Disneyland of pumpkin patches around here. Very crowded.
It gets very crowded.
So we're going, it's before 9. What? I look like a ghost. I had to tap the screen. So we're going early. Also, some baby goats were recently born, so we want to see the baby goats.
This one? This one? This one? This one? This one?
I don't know if we can fit it in the car.
Are we done? One more. This one. Oh no, another pumpkin party too hard.
What now?
Whoopie pies. Let's go. The children are coming. We have to go.
So, success.
Directions home.
All right.
I don't know where
we've been coming here for like 15 years. Do we really need directions home?
I don't know where I am. Help me. I'm lost in upstate New York and I don't know where I am.
All right.
Send me home, Siri.
Empty cornfields again.
We didn't get any corn stalks. Are we going to get corn stalks this year?
We could stop at the hollow.
Look, if we just took a few off the roadside, would they really know? I have a machete in the back.
I would know. And why do you have a machete?
You didn't hear that. Just snip a couple stalks.
That would be theft.
That's what they did. Where do you think they got those?
They probably own the cornfield.
Oh. Well, maybe they would get... Why don't we just take the ones that are around their light post? They can get more.
Is it really that hard to pay $4?
$6. We could have stolen them from the field two miles up.
Are you going to pay?
1, 2, 3. Look at my good wallet. 3, 4, 5, 6. I will buy one group of corn stalks so that I can complain about it all year long. Lucky for you, it was a good night at Big and Lovely. And I've got lots of singles. When you're picking out a corn stalk, which is like $1 a stalk, by the way, free a mile back, it's a bonus if you get the corn on the bottom.
It looks so rude.
It looks rude, doesn't it? Doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's like, am I happy to see you, or is that just my corn stalk? Ew. Why did we take your car?
This is why. Every year my car gets dirty. It's your turn.
Well, every year my car gets needles in it for 365 days.
Am I riding on the roof?
Go ahead, get in. You wanted the stalks. You were like, we need corn stalks. I need to get me some corn stalks. This isn't going to work for me. You have to wrangle that.
Oops.
Don't break it. Oh no! I just cleaned my car! From our sponsor.
Product placement, Cutco knives. For all your Cutco needs, Spencer Glenn.
Spencer Glenn.
And if Cutco ever wants to design a pumpkin carving kit, I'll buy two.
So we got all these cute little bags.
So we got slinkies. These are little.
This one.
Gerbil.
And this one.
A gerbil.
And we'll stuff them with goodies, and then we'll seal them with these fun stickers.
There's little stampers
that you can use with your little
notepads.
Those are cute. Aren't they cute?
Cute, cute, cute.
Oh, eyeballs.
No, these were double eyeballs.
Oh yeah. Turn your finger into a creature.
I bet it glows. Does it glow? Oh, I bet they glow.
There's lots of candy too.
Oh,
so let's see. Let's do a test bag and see. Oh, we gotta open the candy. You'll notice the candy is actually already opened because someone broke the rule.
No, we served it to guests that were over.
I'm sorry, that's breaking the rule. Guests or no guests.
Okay, I put the eyeballs on her tail.
Oh. Oh, look what he did. Let me see. Let me kill it. So we've got.
What are you doing?
Chocolate.
Yes.
And then, what did you call this one? That's like the filler.
That's the crap
candy. The crap candy.
Crap grab.
You know, it's not. It's like Twizzlers and Swedish candy. It's the non chocolate.
This is the left Twix. Because I'm a lefty.
These are big.
I'm not talking about my hands.
That's big enough. Let's see. How much candy do you think? 2 pieces of chocolate, 2 pieces of crap. We're already full. What?
Pick a toy. And an eyeball.
What are you doing? That's for the children. Boop. So this has a pad, a stamper, a ring, and
you're trying to put everything on there.
4 pieces of candy.
So Trixie and I were busy.
We can fill them to the max. Look, little spider on an orange
adorable
background. How cute.
Adorable.
Oh. Happy Halloween.
Wait.
60. Don't eat all the almond joys. How many do we make?
We made 3. It's time to have a candy.
You've already had several.
Look at the size of me. I can't have several. I need many. They did put us on the Onondaga page that this was the good street to go on.
Jolly Rancher. Milky Way. Oops.
Ah. It's question time. It's Ryberts question time.
All right. What were some of your favorite houses that you went trick-or-treating at? Down in Flushing.
Down in Flushing.
Where you'd have to trick or treat with a knife because you didn't know when you'd get jumped. Ooh.
I used to like to go to the McMahons because they were around the corner from us on 168th Street. It's because Mrs. McMahon would dress up as a witch.
Mm-hmm.
There wasn't much to it. She'd have spooky music playing. Mm-hmm. She'd come to the door dressed as a witch. She had a big bowl of candy.
Mm.
And people loved going. They would try to go twice. But she would be like, all right, do you okay, Moretti? You can't have any candy this time.
She did a little character thing.
Oh, yeah. She was
into it.
She did it. My non-favorite house.
Oh, you had a non-favorite house.
Yes. I mean, I still went.
They gave you a nickel.
No. Close. They lived, ironically, directly across the street from my band, the Gazelters.
The Gazelters.
So if you're watching, hi Gazelters. And they would come to the door with, like, we used to have one of those too. It's like a long, narrow platter, like stainless steel. Mm-hmm. You know, they were like a 70s thing.
Yeah.
And it would be full of single sticks of double mint gum. Or Wrigley's. Well, Wrigley's is double mint. Some kind of gum.
Horrible.
And you would get a stick of gum. Woohoo! And you?
Oh, thanks for asking, Laura.
You're welcome, Cabrina.
Well, my grandparents lived down the way from a guy who sold Ghirardelli.
I didn't know there was your
That's mine.
Peppermint.
So you would go down to his house, and he would give out normal candy to everybody. And what you had to do was say...
Password?
Yeah, pretty much. I'm Tiny Smith's grandkid, because my grandfather was kind of a big deal.
Was he literally big? Was he like 8 feet tall?
Man was like 6'5" or something like that. And big. He was a big dude.
And they called him Tiny, because they were funny. They're funny, those Californians.
So you would tell him that, and he'd go, hold on just a minute. And he'd duck behind the door. And when he came back around, he would have a freaking Wonka bar in his hand. And then otherwise, all I did was I would stop and listen.
Ever listen for screaming?
There was music or screaming coming from. That's where I wanted to go. I really cared less about the candy. I just wanted to go wherever there was some sort of haunted house thing happening. The best one was a guy who lined the entire entryway of his house with tin foil. So it was all shiny. And then he had a chair at the end of the entry on a little, like a throne.
So you had to go into the house?
And then he had strobe lights. So the entire thing would flash and you couldn't tell which way was up. It also inspired me to save my allowance and buy a strobe light at Radio Shack.
Radio Shack.
You're still dating yourself. Still have it.
They don't make things like these.
I use it every Halloween, and I think about that guy in the tin foil. Adorable. All right. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22.
22.
If you have five families with at least five kids show up, you're out.
That would be the first time in the history of Halloween that we had five families with five kids.
Not true.
Creak and the tombstones quake.
Spooks and mockers wane and wake.
Happy haunts materialize
and begin to vocalize.
Grim, grinning ghosts are out to socialize. Now don't close your eyes and don't try to hide.
Or a silly spook may sit by your side.
Shrouded in a darkish hide.
They pretend to terrorize.
When we ghosts come out to socialize. As the moon climbs high o'er the dead oak tree,
spooks arrive for the midnight spree.
Creepy creeps with eerie eyes,
starts to shriek and harmonize. When we ghosts come out to socialize.
When you hear the knell of a requiem bell,
weird ghosts game where spirits dwell.
Restless bones etherealize,
rise as spooks of every size.
When the crypt doors creak and the tombstones quake, spooks come out for a swinging wake. Happy hearts materialize and begin to vocalize. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
Now don't close your eyes and don't try to hide, or a silly spook may sit by your side, shrouded in a daft disguise.
They pretend to terrorize. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
Wrong. Next up, Diamond.
Is that me?
Yes. Is my name?
Yep.